I want to share a thought that I had with you just the other day, and it comes from Acts chapter 1, and it's here in verse chapter 4. It says, "Gathering them together, he," that's Jesus, "commanded them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait for what the Father had promised," which begs the question, what did the Father promise? "Which," he said, "you heard of from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now." Which begs the question, why tell them to wait? Why didn't you just baptize them right there on the spot, Jesus, with the Holy Spirit before you ascended to be at the right hand of the Father? What is up with waiting? Why not do it right there when you are in their midst? What's the point? What do we learn? What's the significance? Why would you have them wait? And I feel like I just want to share with you guys just a couple of observations that I felt like the Lord had shared with me, because we have been talking about in these vlogs the last few, probably over a month and a half now, about the importance of the number one thing we should be asking for right now is more of the Holy Spirit, and understanding that without Him, there is no book of Acts. There is no genuine, true Christianity that's lived out and demonstrated apart from the Holy Spirit. So here's what I think is going on here. Number one, I think this is about obedience. I think, guys, if we are not walking in it, we should be waiting for it. I also believe this. I believe that it builds an appreciation. Anytime we're waiting for something, when we receive it, it builds an appreciation for what it is we've received. We learn how to store it. We learn how to cherish it. And I believe the Holy Spirit is wanting to be adored, wanting to be cherished, wanting to be sought after. And I believe that when we receive more of Him, when we're clothed with power from on high to not just preach the gospel, but to demonstrate it, we have an appreciation for the one that's upon us. We learn how to love Him, walk with Him, hear Him. We learn how to know what He thinks, you know, hear His thoughts and know what He feels. And we live in such a way that brings Him honor and glory. And we live in such a way that attracts His presence and doesn't repel it. And the last thing I want to say is this. I believe there's something about waiting for the person of the Holy Spirit, waiting to be filled with who He is, waiting to be baptized with Him, that builds unity. It says here also in this chapter that they were, in verse 14, they were continually with one mind, devoting themselves to prayer. And I believe, and this is what it means to be of one mind. When you bring people, when you rally them around one purpose, one thing, and they're of one accord, in other words, they see the importance of what they're doing and why they're doing it. It's what it means to be of one accord, and they're committed to that one purpose. And I believe unity is found in being of one mind. They knew what they were praying for. They knew what they were told to wait for, and it brought unity to them, and they were continually night and day interceding for what was promised to them. So this is what I believe. I believe that we are going to begin to see a unity fall within the church. I believe we're going to start to see prayer meetings spring up, upper room moments where people are committing themselves to seeking this one thing, unified around one purpose, because they understand and they realize that what they currently are walking in is not enough. And because we're not walking in it, we should be waiting for it. And I believe it's an obedient thing. We need to learn how to be obedient in this hour to what the Spirit is saying to us. And I believe He is saying, wait. Wait till you receive power from on high. Because you heard that not many days from now, you heard that John the Baptist baptized with water, but not many days from now, you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. I pray that this blesses you guys. I pray that you're stirred as much as I am. I have never felt this hungry before. And I'm believing that we are going to see an outpouring, but there's no outpouring without an upper room. Bless you guys. Like the video, share it, get it out there. Let people know what's going on and what the Spirit of God is saying. If you're not subscribed, make sure you click subscribe, turn on the notification bell so you get notifications when we release these videos, which are on a weekly basis. I love you. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.